There are many British and New Zealand graves on the island of Crete.
Guglielmo Marconi was aboard his yacht Electra, making his latest radio experiments. Without him, today there might have been no radio broadcasting. Thousands of unnecessary lives might have been lost at sea.
Signor De Gasperi, Democrat leader and head of the new Italian Republic. Even after the election, excitement grips Italy in the last act of the drama of the Royal House of Savoy. King Umberto was rejected by a narrow margin in a nationwide vote.
Holland, confined to his room by an attack of influenza, the ex-Kaiser Wilhelm of Germany. He is 78 years old, and he caught a cold while at his usual exercise of wood chopping.
In my opinion, the most likely cause would be a very rapid decompression of the cabin due to a structural failure, perhaps, or a failure of a large valve.
And the BBC's television department has a sizable repair job on its hands.
This is Jean Metcalf speaking.
Here are further pictures of the Allied drive through Syria. Night and day artillery duels preceded the victorious advance on Damascus, the capital city. Empire and Free French troops, including colonial units from the Cameroons, press onward along the road leading into the mother city of the world.
Everyone rejoiced that the Princess Elizabeth had married the man she loved, though we didn't know him so well then. Some of us knew that he'd been born far away upon the romantic Greek island of Corfu. Yes, a prince from over the seas, Philip of the Hellenes.
I'm not too happy to say that because it reveals that obviously there were a number of things that I didn't know about or was not told about. In fact, I never even heard of these papers during the time that I campaigned for the presidency.